Okay, so I'm gonna do some black bean empanadas. Kind of pull out whatever I have. What's the recipe? Well, it's using a flour, but it mixes the cornmeal. I bought some of this. I mean, I'll see whether I'll do with the red bus. I could do it with the red bus rather than just corn and flour. That's an idea. Okay. Well, I'm gonna pull out what I got. Okay, we got some onions to use up. This is the chayote. It's got some corn. It was the gatine. Well, these were the peanuts. I mean, I could put again this on top. The caramelized peanuts. It's more oriental. Well, these artichokes. I don't think I want to put artichokes. Artichokes came out again. And I had done a chipotle. Well, let me put those in. We'll see. Because the only cheese I have left, I think, is blue. Could be interesting, I don't know. With the blue and the artichoke. And, well, let's try it. I have a bit of this crab. I'll put that in there as well. Kind of debating whether I guess I could try each. Because the arepa doesn't, to put all of this in, I better put the flour down there.
Never negotiate with screws again.
what Mexican chili, and we'll put a little bit of oregano, not too much. So coriander and cumin. The crab.
Parsley.
caldo de pollo de, bouillon. In French. Bouillon. Well, how to say it in English anymore. Yeah.
Thank you. Unfortunately.
Democrats.
Okay, so I don't know why, but I bought to put a bead in this, so. Black beans. Oh, we'll see how this comes out. I'm gonna actually do this raw and grate it. And grate some carrots. Saute that. Never grated chayote. Maybe try that. Kind of fry that up. Put it in with the black beans. And then blue cheese. I have some sour cream I need to use up, so that'll help. And also buy it. Well, I could try some with that, and then another with the artichoke. Which gives a kind of a difference. Also have some stuff. Well, this. Usually for a Colombian dish. This is Guascas. It's usually, and I really like this, it's a Colombian stew with chicken and different types of potatoes. And I mean, I'm more partial. That's one of my favorite. Like if they have that meat, I'll usually order that. I prefer that, but it is very good. As I say, it's a stew. So I have that. Let's see what that does. That's very unkosher. This was chili arbol molido. Achiote. Anybody who doesn't like I'll put a big beef in there. A couple of anybody who doesn't like spicy food, garlic and onions, better not come over to my house to eat. Pretty much spicy, but I'll put a little bit of jalapeno, garlic, I mean, I'm really getting tired of the, the news is nothing but an entertainment center. Entertainment propaganda. And it is dangerous. I mean, oh my God, this guy Jim, he sits there, listen to that, and thinks he's informed. Tells me I'm a stupid idiot. God, he's the typical. Intellect wannabe. Oh God, I'm so tired. That's a product of managerialism. Everybody wants to be an intellect. That's what destroyed my mother. People that think that they read and they read and they read and they read and they read. 3,000 books. 3,000 books. For nothing. I mean, I don't remember every book and everything of every book that I read, but okay, it depends on, but a hell of a lot. Enough to know at least, well, this was a good book. Taught me some stuff. If I want to quote from it, I gotta reread it again. And the other one was bullshit. So, I mean, and across the board, I mean, oh my God. When I was young, I mean, literature. One time a friend of mine came up to me and she pulled the book out of my hand and she, come on out. And, no, because when I would get into my books. Like the world disappears. My mom said to me, a couple years before she passed, she said, oh my God, when you were born, you just had this such tranquil look upon your face as if you knew what the world was about. And I said, well, if I had known what the world was about, I wouldn't have had a tranquil look upon my face. I would have been saying, send me back. And at least she said touche. I'll give her that. She said touche. Thank you. he hit her, and he was going, isn't that colder than assault? Now, when I was literally, like, my doors are broken. I mean, these huge doors, I have barriers that he's broken through. The cops in Spain are telling me, lady, it's his house, he can break anything he wants. And CNN is ignoring me, as is the Spanish consulate. Excuse me, the American consulate in Madrid. It pisses me off because it's hypocritical. Totally hypocritical. And they find a way to cash in on the death of these poor women. Yeah. And they're all over the map. Till it killed. Who gives a shit? And she sounds as conflictual as him. Now, the thing is, of course, she's not dangerous enough, unless she pulls out, you know, a weapon, to kill him. Or, you know, I mean, I'm sure it was an accidental death. Accidental in the sense that he might have lost it or something. I don't think it was premeditated. From listening to the stuff, and I've listened to too many cases, I don't think it was premeditated. Is it still a murder? Yes, it still is. But we gotta stop these couples who are escalating like this. Instead of, oh, we don't want to get involved, we don't get involved until somebody actually get killed. I'm sorry, everybody in this freaking case is a victim. Even the guy who killed her. As I say, it doesn't say he's not like a freaking serial killer. It doesn't sound like it was premeditated. It sounds like it was an explosive relationship that was going to end. Excuse me, the parents, you know, these explosive kids, that's what you're bringing up. I know that's so politically incorrect to blame the parents, but we gotta start blaming the parents. I'm sorry. Or B, perhaps he's someplace else, or C, he don't, he's
installation, the light contracts are on the warranty. And hey, I don't know if you back on that lighter.
We feel that this works flawlessly, filtering out these three.
So how has light changed since we pulled it?
It's less complicated. My motors are clogged and that keeps me stress free. Thanks to the filter, we were able to put the ladder away. Makes us feel good.
So I take it you'd recommend leaf filter?
Absolutely. All my things are made now. Leaf filter is a no-brainer.
Call 823 Leaf Filter or go to getleaffilter.com for your free gutter inspection and estimate. Call or log on today and save 15%.
Thank you.
Chris Cuomo accused of sexual harassment. Don Lemon, he's saying he was a victim of sexual harassment when he was young. I mean, if you're going to speak out, make it for something other than just profiting from it. I mean, that's... As I keep on saying, the only thing anybody will find about my personal case, well, with my American family, that's gotten into. But what started all of this 15 years ago, relatively little is said about who's getting privacy rights. I don't want to talk about that stuff on a public forum. You know, that's why I wanted to go through the proper procedures within the court systems and deal with it where it needs to be dealt with and not on a public forum. But the court systems want to cover it up, so, you know, I've had to come out in public. I have tried to keep this on legal issues, political issues, social issues, economic issues, public policy issues, and not my personal issues. And nobody listens, so, you know. Everybody loves a scandal and sensationalism like this. Pisses me off. I've lost 15 years of my goddamn life for that. And I mean, you know, a lot of people have lost a lot more than I have and have been damaged a lot more than I, and I'm aware of that. But it's still, I'm still pissed off about what I've lost in terms of my children, in terms of my life, in terms of my time, in terms of everything. And I'm entitled to that. I mean, you know, we can be pissed off about our own stuff and do something about it and still be pissed off and want justice for ourselves as well as everybody else. We need everybody to go out and vote for the Democrats. And that's how we're going to solve everything. Thank you.
mama out there saying that the rich can pick up the tab for the spending bill. Of course they can. It's a measly, what is it, $3 trillion? They injected $3 trillion into through the Fed and those beans. Let's just throw our money around, keep on throwing our money around. And we can get Bitcoin going, you know, up and away like everything else and produce it all. And then we'll end up with ourselves with the third world. Thank you very much, Mr. O'Biden. Thank you very much, Mr. Obama. Thank you very much, Mr. Biden. Thank you very much, Mr. Trump. Mr. Clinton, Mr. Bush's, and Mr. Reagan. Everybody does debt financing these days. Why not?
under threat right now. The pandemic of the unvaccinated is raging. Mitch McConnell announcing that he got his booster shot today.
I'd like to share that a few minutes ago I received a booster vaccination for COVID-19. Was it easy to say to receive a booster? I'm a survivor of childhood polio from before vaccines. Before vaccines eradicated that disease here in our country and around the world now. So I've been a lifelong champion of vaccinations.
Joe Biden got his booster shot today on live TV. Now imagine how different things would have been if his predecessor had done the same thing.
Like, it's just so pulverized. Screaming and yelling out there. I think it's domestic. Just, you know, dispute. I mean, it's out. The woman who is the one who's doing most of the screaming and everything, so, but I've called the cops more than once, though. It's right at the corner of Mount Pleasant.
Thank you.
It really gets me tired to have a we're willing to have a conversation. We're all willing to have a conversation. Let's get into conversation. No different than the gossiping at country clubs of the ruling elite women. Let them have their conversation there, but not on taxpayers' money. Drugs is this one on? I'm sorry.
Don't tell me this isn't
Stepford Wild bullshit.
Touch of cinnamon.
What a touch, touch.
Thank you.
population that's eligible for receiving the booster. I certainly think anyone over the age of 65 and those who live in long-term care facilities should seek out a booster shot. That's the age group that the CDC and FDA agree upon should be going to get boosters right now. For those under the age of 65, the authorization allows people who have medical conditions to put at heightened risk of COVID to receive boosters, as well as those who have excessive occupational exposure that could put them at risk of severe COVID infection, including healthcare workers, road control workers, other kinds of first responders.
Okay, so I'm frying them. The grated. Beet, and it was a one grated beet and a half of, it was a big carrot. So I'm kind of, you know, grilling, frying it in a bit of oil. To cook, but not really lose all of its crispness. And I mean, it gets rid of a lot of water. Salads that I love, which is French. You know, you can do it with canned beets, but boil the beets, chop them up, garlic and a vinaigrette. I was like, ooh, I never liked beets when I was growing up because my mom, the only thing I ever had was canned beets. But,
year. natural infection. It's not going to be in perpetuity. It's not going to be forever. Eventually, that cohort is going to have to get vaccinated to sustain their protection against this virus.
Very important. Great. That's why I asked this panel to reiterate that. Doctor, thank you so much. And again, the doctor's book is Uncontrolled Spread, Why COVID-19 Can Defeat the Next Pandemic. There it is up on the screen. It's good. Thanks to Dr. Duffy. So he said that they're not vaccinated. They shouldn't be taking vaccinated. Her name was Lamar. It is over the vaccine. Not his name. He's here to explain next. I was just asking next
to the vaccine office.
Quite a big chunk. Need to use it up. I'm thinking this could be really good as well for a filling with the Italian rice bowl, a little like that. And you can do all sorts of fillings for that. And it's good finger food, but like, quarter of a cup or so.
What about the folks who say, hey, listen, it's my right?
Sour cream in. Force everybody to do what is correct. It's called applying the law. Blue cheese. And the sour cream. This is good. As I say, this would be good in the Italian rice ball in the center. Quite a few things going on because I got the crab, I got the black beans, and then the grated carrots. progress. Okay, it's got one cup flour, 1/2 cup butter, 3 ounces of cream cheese, and 1/4 cup of cornmeal. And salt. Okay, so butter.